CBS presents this program in color.
Last time, as you recall, on Lost in Space, escape from Earth.
This is Alpha Control. Countdown to liftoff. 4 hours, 3 minutes, 37 seconds, and counting.
All systems are green and go for launch.
Reveals Smith is here.
Dr. Smith?
William, you don't know how delighted I am to finally see you again. I heard you were being held down here, and I simply had to come and see you.
You made it back to Earth, Dr. Smith. You made it.
Gently, dear boy, gently. You know my delicate back is a disaster area.
I can't believe you're alive.
I won't be if you continue to crush my delicate spine. Oh, the pain. The pain.
How long have you been back?
3 long and lonely years, William. But now that you're here, there are so many things we can do together. Unless, of course, you're still angry with me.
Angry for what? Leaving us behind or trading our robot for a one-man spaceship to that alien space trader?
Both, actually. But you must believe me, I did it for the good of the entire Robinson Menage. I intended to send a rescue ship as soon as I landed here on Earth, but Alpha Control wouldn't allow it. And they kept me locked up here ever since.
I know. I've already been filled in with the huge conspiracy cover-up that's going on at Alpha Control.
And you couldn't possibly be upset with me for trading that rusty rolling bucket of bolts for a spaceship, could you?
The robot was my friend.
So was I, wasn't I? And didn't you want your dear friend, Dr. Smith, to make it back home? Your dear, dear friend, Dr. Smith? Who was never even supposed to be in outer space to begin with? Oh, please say you'll forgive me, William, please. Wait, Will! I almost forgot. I have something for you. I've been saving this for you for all these years.
The robot's memory tapes! You saved them?
The space trader wanted them naturally, but I refused to budge on it during our negotiations. He even offered to throw in a gross of canned food to sustain me during my long journey home, which I dearly desired. But I held firm, so that one day I could present them to you in the hopes that you would forgive me for trading in the robot.
You have no idea how much they mean to me.
Oh, but I do. Because now all you have to do is put those tapes into a brand new robot servo unit, and presto, you'll have your old robot again. Of course, why you'd want that Neolithic ninny back is beyond my comprehension.
Thank you, Dr. Smith.
Oh, Will, I have one more gift for you.
What is that?
Didn't you wonder how I was able to open your door? This keycard gives you complete access to the whole of Alpha Control.
How did you get that?
It fell into my possession when the General wasn't looking.
Why didn't you use it to escape?
And go where? I'm old, Will, and I'm tired. I'm well fed and well cared for here. It's like being at a resort, really.
A resort? You can't leave.
But you can. I'll even show you how to get to a launch pad where there just so happens to be a spaceship fueled up and ready for flight.
But won't you get in trouble if you help me escape?
Not if my plan works. Now follow me.
Are you sure?
Never fear. Smith is still here.
This is Alpha Control. Countdown to launch is 1 hour, 53 minutes, and counting. Attention, the Allen family is now due for their pre-liftoff final physical checks.
Am I okay, Doctor? Did I pass?
You'll do.
Did you hear that, Sheila? I'm okay.
Yes, Erwin, I heard. We weren't worried, were we?
Listen up, General. I'm getting out of here.
Indeed. You are 8 floors underground, deep within the bowels of Alpha Control, surrounded by many armed guards and many more locked doors. There is no getting out of here. Tell him, Zack.
Zack? Indeed. By the way, I have no idea where he got that dangerous weapon. Will, be careful with that thing. We could all be killed.
I'm leaving, and I'm taking Dr. Smith as my hostage. Anyone tries to stop me, and Dr. Smith gets it.
Did you hear that, dear nephew? He's forcing me to help him escape. Against my will, I'm his prisoner.
You think you're going to escape dragging a 65-year-old man with you?
Bah! I'm 39.
Let's move.
Just remember, he's making me do this. I'm an unwilling participant, a hostage, a victim, an innocent lamb thrown into a den of wolves.
We must hurry.
These doors are going to open in exactly 8 floors. At that point, you'll have only a good 30 seconds to open the top of the gantry and get inside the Jupiter 22 before the guards catch on and try and stop you.
I guess this is goodbye again, Dr. Smith.
At least this time I get to say adieu, William. William, you must go now.
Alpha Control is now under emergency lockdown. Intruders on the launch pad. Intruders on the launch pad. Security breach. Security breach. Destroying anyone on the launch pad. All intruders must be destroyed.
Will! Oh, William, help! Will, wait for me!
Repeat, destroy anyone on the launch pad.
Wait for me!
All intruders must be destroyed.
Faster, Will! Faster!
All intruders must be destroyed.
Oh. William, did I ever mention to you that I'm terrified of heights?
Stop them! Disobey a direct order.
Thrusters at full power. We're about to break free of Earth's atmosphere.
No, Will. William, you must turn this thing around. I was only supposed to help you escape. I can't go back out into space. Not now. Not me, not again. I'm too old, too frail, too fragile.
What do you want me to do, Dr. Smith? We can't go back.
Couldn't you just drop me off at Manitou Junction?
Sorry, Dr. Smith, but those guards were trying to kill us.
Are you sure? The General is, after all, a blood relative of mine. Are you sure he really means me harm?
There's something approaching fast. You better see what it is.
William! It's a rocket, and it's headed straight for us! Do something, we'll both be killed!
Stay tuned to this YouTube channel for the next chapter of Lost in Space, Escape from Earth.